Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, let me tell you a brief idea about galvanic cell. Galvanic cell is the cell in which the electricity is being obtained. So the main example of this cell is nothing but the Daniell cell that we are going to talk about. So let us see what is Daniell cell and what are the construction involved in it. So the Daniell cell is an example of a galvanic cell in which two half cells are being involved. So in this case, as you can see, the electricity has been obtained and there are presence of two half cells, that is this one and this one. Two half cells are being present in this cell. So the one cell, that is for the left one, if I would say, this involves zinc electrode, which is acting like an anode. And while on the other side, it is the copper, which is present as a cathode. And again, since it is present on the right hand side, and according to the IUPAC notification, that we should represent the cathode on the right hand side. So therefore, this act like a cathode. And now the main thing, this electrode is being dipped in a solution of 1 molar ZnSO4 solution, while that of the copper is being dipped in 1 molar CuSO4 solution. And to connect this two electrically, it is connected by a galvanometer or a device that could measure the amount of electricity that has been produced. And while in this case, to connect it electrically, we have connected it by a salt bridge. This is the salt bridge, which consists of K plus ions and Cl minus ions. So let me tell you that this device is based on the principle of the galvanic cell, in which the chemical reaction occurs and the electricity is being produced. So in this case, since zinc is acting like an anode, it will undergo oxidation. And while the cathode, which is undergoing reduction, in this case Cu2 plus ions that are present, they will get deposited on the copper electrode, that is on the cathode. And this KCl will act as a connector between these two half cells. This will connect the two half cells electrically and will avoid the liquid junction potential. So what are the uses of this also? Let me give you an idea by drawing the cell reaction, or by giving you that what could be the working involved in this Daniell cell so as to produce electricity. So let me tell you the working first. So since zinc is acting like an anode, so therefore at anode always oxidation occurs. So therefore, zinc will give Zn2 plus 2 electrons. So in this case, what I am talking about? In this case, the zinc will oxidize and it will form Zn2 plus ion as well as 2 electrons. So zinc will get dissolved in ZnSO4 solution and it will produce 2 electrons. So that 2 electrons will travel from anode to cathode, and the solution that is in which ZnSO4 is present, it will have an increased quantity of Zn2 plus ions. So it means the quantity of Zn, which is present in solid form after oxidation, will go on decreasing, and hence this Zn2 plus oxidizes, this Zn electrode oxidizes to form Zn2 plus. So now moving towards the next one, that is at cathode, reduction occurs, and in this process this anode, which is exhibiting or which is removing the electrons from it, it will act like a negative electrode, while this will act like a positive electrode. So the thing that will happen is this positive electrode will give the chance to Cu2 plus ions that are present in the CuSO4 solution, and in this case Cu2 plus ions will get deposited or will accept electrons that are being involved in the brought up by the anode towards the cathode. So in this case Cu2 plus will accept two electrons to form Cu, which is present in solid form. So the net cell reaction of the whole one will be, this two will cancel out each other, then the thing that will be formed is Zn, which is present in solid form, it will accept or it will react with the Cu2 plus ion, which is present in aqueous form, to give the reaction and to give the product as Cu2 plus Zn2 plus plus Cu. So this is the overall reaction that we could observe. So let me give you a brief idea that what occurs here. So in this case, the concentration of the both the half cell are same, that is 1 molar and 1 molar. So in this case, the zinc is undergoing oxidation, and if zinc is undergoing oxidation, it will leave electrons and that electrons will travel throughout the circuit by the external circuit, and it will come towards the cathode, while the Zn2 plus will remain in the solution itself. So what will happen towards the KCl? In this thing, if Zn2 plus is being, the concentration of Zn2 plus has been increasing, so therefore since the salt bridge consists of KCl, so the Cl will move towards, which is present in the salt bridge, it will move towards the anode section, while the K plus, which is now turned to be a positive, which is positive one, it will move towards the negative SO4 minus, which are left more in the CuSO4 half cell. So in this case, if these electrons are being deposited on the cathode, so therefore these electrons that are deposited on the cathode, so to neutralize it, this Cu2 plus ions that are present on the in the CuSO4 solution, it will try to grab and it will try to deposit on the copper electrode. And in this case, the SO4 minus or SO4 2 minus concentration will be increased. So that to neutralize, in this case, K plus will come here, and the K plus will travel on the cathode, while the Cl minus will travel on the anode. And the one thing that is to be much more concerned, that the anode value or the anode concentration goes on decreasing, while the cathode's concentration, or when I talk it about the amount of cathode that we could observe, it goes on increasing. So this is how the Daniell cell works. So there is a decrease in the amount of zinc when it is acting like an anode, and there will be increase in amount of copper, because the copper that is present in an aqueous form will deposit on the copper cathode, which is present in solid form. So therefore, this was the main representation of the Daniell cell. But for this, we could write it in a cell formula also. So how can we write? Because in this case, zinc is acting like an anode, and which is dissolved in ZnSO4, and which has a connection of KCl, acting as a salt bridge. And again, it is dipped in CuSO4, and we have cathode as the copper electrode. So I could write the cell formula as, so the cell formula will be Zn, which is solid form, is dissolved in Zn2 plus. In this case, I could write it as ZnSO4 also, which has a concentration of 1 molar. Again, salt bridge is also used. Again, Cu2 plus, which is also of 1 molar, is now being dipped. Copper has been dipped in it. So, in this case, the negative charge will be here and the positive charge will be here. So, this is the cell formula of the Daniell cell. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got an idea that what is Daniell cell, and please share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.